Good day, everyone. Welcome to my latest topic and activity on making of a fiberglass floating cottage and the fish cage. Here in our place, there is a popular trend of having some floating cottages in areas with less or not so attractive beach line, shoreline, and so floating cottage is an answer. Most of the floating cottages are made of bamboo, while at the same time I saw some fish cages that are also made of bamboo and some higher quality that is made of SDPE pipes. So in my case, I would like to make a two-in-one activity wherein the fiberglass float will become a floating cottage and at the same time a fish cage. So I am Jesse Baring. I would like to bring you on the process on how I have made this project possible. Come with me and let's discuss about the pictures that I have taken while we do our fabrication until we have put it in operation. So initially, the first thing that we have to do is to make the floats, and the floats that we are using are those of fiberglass material formed into some boat-like shape so that it could be the one that will support on the platform that we will be installing on it. So these are the sample or the picture of the floater that we will be using instead of barrel that is being used by the bamboo cottages. So we use a fiberglass plates being joined together to form this boat shape material. By the way, we use 10 of these. There are six big boats and four small boats that will be attached into the platform later. I will be showing to you. So here in the left side, you can see the size difference between the small boat and the larger boat that will be used as floater. So the longer boat or the larger boat will be used or attached to the platform that is longitudinal to the its orientation to the platform. And we will be installing three of these attached to the platform. You can see on the right side, there are people working on attaching the boat into the plate that will be the platform of the floater. The attachment is done using fiber mat and the resin to serve as the adhesive. We make sure that this attachment is very strong or else it might be detached while in service when it will be in operation in water. We try to align the big boats, the longer boats, and that we place some gaps in between, thinking that the waves will have to crawl in and die down later. So it will not. It is expected that the platform or the cottage will not be affected much by the change of the waves of the sea. Because you know, the waves of the sea is constantly changing such that if there will be no absorber of the shock from the wave, then it will be not steady in its position. So this is my idea that it should be with a gap so that the waves will die down as it come across the boats. Shown here are the two sides of 1 meter by 6 meter platform, and there are six boats that are attached to it, three on each side. And here the fiberglass application for the connecting points between the platform and the boat is strengthened. Well, we have even used ubin for that, so that the connection will be very strong. Because this connection is one of the most critical area of the design, and we don't want that the boat will be detached from the platform, or else there will be some structural problem later with our design. We make sure that it is very strong. At this point, the boat still don't have the floaters yet that we will be using. We will be using polyurethane foam to fill in the space of the boat, so that it could ensure that the space will not be filled up with water, even the boat will be punctured, so the water cannot come in, or just a little of water will be coming into the boat because the space is occupied with the polyurethane foam. After completely attaching the boats, then we have to flip to the side. You can see the structure of the plates above. We have used GI pipe to strengthen the platform. The pipes are not so many, so there are a few pipes only used. So we expect that the structural integrity of the plates that will be used as platform will be good due to the polyurethane foam that will be pumped into it later, so that the foam will create the holding effect of the plates, and that it will work as one. So this is our desire and our expectation, that the platform will still be very strong despite that there is a few pipes that we have used. Now we have opened up a hole in just above the boat so that we can pour in polyurethane foam into it. So here is the process. The white can is the one that is being used to mix the polyurethane foam and then pour immediately into the hole so that it could occupy all the space in the boat. So one boat could consume about 3 liters of paired A and B of the polyurethane chemical. So with 6 boats, we will consume about 18 liters each of the A and B of polyurethane chemical. On the right side, you can see that the hole is already completely filled up with polyurethane, and we will close it back with the piece that we have taken off. Now these are the two main platform that we'll be using, and we are now installing the sidings of the platform to form the space where we will again pour in polyurethane foam into it. So the size of the platform is 1 meter by 6 meter by 15 centimeter. The 15 centimeter is the thickness of the platform. Here we check the strength of the single platform, the base of the platform, by lifting it up, and it is also to ensure that the polyurethane foam will be covering the other side of the boat completely. So on the left side, after completely doing the sidings and the upper portion of the platform, the polyurethane foam is also poured into it. And above the platform, you can see the latitudinal part member of the platform that is put on top of it. So here in the left side, we can see that this is already the complete parts that we'll be installing at the or assembling at the site, at the beach site that where we will be floated. Because the we cannot install or assemble this floater here, for it is too big and no car or no truck can carry it to the site. So we have to assemble on site. So on the right side, this is the four members of the floater that is now being connected on site using fiberglass material again and strengthening it very well, because this could be the weakest point of the platform, so we have to strengthen it and make sure that it is well connected to each other. And here is the completed platform that we have connected already, and we have installed the posts. We use PVC material as posts so that it will be lightweight, and this will carry the roofing that we will be using. We'll be using tarp material as roofing because we want it to be lightweight. So this is almost ready, and we are just waiting for the roping or rope to be completed. And once it's completed, we can proceed with the testing or floating test of the cottage if it is balanced. So we don't know if we can get a good balance of this, or we still have to see it in actual putting up this one into the sea. Now we have here completed with the post, and we have already put in place the roofing material that we intend to use, and that we are ready to float now. And on the right side, we have manually lifted up the cottage so that it could get into the sea. And luckily, we have a good flotation as expected. We have about 3 inches of clear space between the platform and the floater boat. Right here, we will be showing you the video of the activities that I have described earlier. So this is the actual working of the floating cottage, attaching the boat floater into the form. And here you can see the actual person that is doing the job, putting up fiber mat and even some bobbin to strengthen the connection between the boat and the platform. This is the bottom base of the platform, and we have to strengthen it to be fiberglass. So here is the application of the polyurethane foam into the boat floater. So we have to do it slowly so that we can fill up the boat completely. Continue, so it takes a long time also to fill in, because you cannot just mix one big mix. So This is the picture, the view of the polyurethane foam under the floater, the boat floater here. So this is the appearance of the boat. This is now the video of when we started with testing or the float testing of the cottage. So several men who manually have to lift up this floating cottage into the sea. So we don't know yet if this structure will be floating well, so we're still guessing at this stage. But anyway, you can see that one part of the cottage is already in the water, and very soon we will know what is its condition when it reaches into the water. So here it is. So, okay, so then we found out that okay, the cottage floats well, and all of these people who are lifting the cottage to the sea is also riding. Let it move. So there are about 16 person here, and still you have a lot of space available. So we thought that this could carry about 30 person. So there is a pool in the middle. It's really nice to take a ride in this one. So however, we know our motor is not very big, so we have to use the manual pushing so that we can get back to where we started, because we are going by the current. So now, this is now the final stage when we have already completed the some correction of the cottage when we have first loaded it. Still manual lifting of the cottage into the sea. Here, we have already a table. So, the chairs are being fixed into the platform. This will be filled by a pump where it could be stationed. Now it's getting closer to visibility. At this time that we have put into the water, the tide is not very high. So longer distance to water to reach the water. Then all of those people who are helping right, and riding, everyone is riding into the sea. So we're now floating. We use plastic material to serve as a fence so that it will not be public people. Yes, the coming in. At this time, there are 22 people expected. So we reach our destination here. Seawater is calm this time. It's early morning, and we will be see the pump boat is still pulling up as the and then now you can see the water that is running on the pool. So while it is being filled up, the tumble. This floating cottage is being stationed or anchored about 200 meters away from the shoreline. So you can see the shoreline from the point of anchorage. So still, the people are helping us in lifting the weights are waiting for the final destination. This is you can see the buoy there, and then this is the final destination already, and we'll be putting up some heavy concrete material to make the floating cottage stay in place. We have So we are in about 5 bottoms deep in the distance, the deepness of the sea. The children are installed. So that's all for our floating cottage. We are still making for or installing for the cage here that will be here in the pool.
At this point, there is no screen yet, but we are soon to put up the screen.
Thank you very much for watching, and hope that you get something and with our presentation today.